here now.
Well, they forced my hand. I'm going to call the police.
555-3000.
Thanks, Dad. Trying to mess with Dr. Fraser Crane. I'll teach them. Hello, yes. Oh, just a second. Dad, who do I ask for?
I haven't put you through to the fine arts forgery department.
Right. Hello, yes, the fine arts forgery department, please. Dad, they're laughing at me.
15 minutes out, a flock of Canadian geese flew into one of our engines. They were the lucky ones. Next thing you know, we're falling 5,000 feet. Smokehouse almonds are flying everywhere. People are screaming and hugging each other. The guy in the next seat grabbed a hold of my hand. And you know what? I didn't pull it away. Then our pilot comes out. Our landing gear's out. We're gonna have to do an emergency belly landing in 6 feet of foam. So, five hellish minutes later, we're bouncing across the runway. Then the stewardess comes out and says we're gonna have to go down the emergency slide. So down I go, head first into this sea of foam. Last thing I remember, this fat lady from across the aisle comes barreling down the chute after me like a polyester avalanche.
My God, Dad, I am so sorry.
So these stewardesses, were they also covered with foam?
Will you stop it?
Dad, if you'd like to talk about it, we're both here for you.
Boy, I tell you, times like this, you just... all you can think of is your loved ones and how you wish you'd spent more time with them.
Eddie!
Ed, are you all right? Oh, I didn't upset you, did I? My God, Dad, are you crying?
No.
Yes, you are. I just saw you wipe your eyes.
No, I didn't. I just quit looking at me.
Dad.
Oh, my God. I made my father cry.
Dad, don't you stop.
Oh, God. I'm only crying because you're crying.
I'm not crying. I don't know what this is. I didn't even cry when I got shot.
I didn't cry when you got shot either.
Get rid of that dead painting right now. I just wish I knew why you told the waiter you loved it so much.
I was lying to
him. You can lie to him, but you can't lie to me.
Please stop crying. I want to keep it now.
No, it's no good.
No, it is good. It's very good. I love it.
Well, I found the...
Dad, are you crying? Fraser, what happened? Oh, my God, you're crying, too. Why is everybody crying? You know how I get when other people cry. Tell me what happened.
I made our father cry.
I'm not crying.
Well, I am. I'm the most ungrateful son there is.
I could never do anything for my son.
No one wants to come to my party.
Say, do you feel like getting a drink?
Yeah, that'd be nice, Marty.
You know, this is such a prime spot here. I think maybe one of us should stay here and the other one get the drinks.
You're right.
So I'll have a beer.
Okay. Oh, shoot. I think I lost an earring.
Oh, there it is, by my foot. There you go.
Thanks. Enjoy the party.
You see, this is the problem. I know everything you're gonna say. First of all, you start talking about 65 as being some sort of passage. And then you'll start spouting these theories and quoting Freud and who knows what else until by the time you get through analyzing me, I'm gonna be 66. Now look, when I tell Agatha something, you know what he does? Nothing. He just listens to me.
We listen. That's my slogan. I'm listening.
We do, you know,
Dad,
pay us
God
a great
sake,
deal of money
is,
to
is
listen.
The foundation of our
pay. Hey,
right.
Shh. Shh. When I saw Agatha's today, it was kind of a shock to see how old he's gotten. And I just made me realize how old I've gotten.
Dad, you still have a lot of...
No, come on,
sorry.
Please.
Sorry.
Look, it's not a problem you can solve, Fraser. It's just a fact of life. People get old.
Well, I guess this horse wasn't quite the banner gift I thought it would be.
Oh, yes, it was, Niles. I'm feeling a little bit sorry for myself right now, but I'll get over that. But I love this horse. It's the greatest present I've ever got.
William said, tell me, you wanted me.
My father said I wanted you.
Hey,
hold it down. There are people here trying to sleep.
Oh, my ears must have popped.
I can hear again.
Well, good night, all.
You can come back from around the corner now, Martin.
Good night, Lilith.
Good night.
You were eavesdropping?
It was an accident, and I only heard the part about her wanting to have another baby with you.
She completely threw me.
Well, I don't know why you're so surprised. She's seen what the Crane genes can do, and she's coming back to the well.
How does one respond to something like that?
Well, I bet if you say no, she'll go to Niles.
You know, it's just so self-centered of her. You know, she's got this all figured out for herself without the slightest consideration for my life.
And Niles will say no for sure. Which means only one thing. She'll come to the source. Me. The fountainhead.
What?
Can you imagine? Lilith's and my kid would be brothers to you and Niles and Freddie.
What are you talking about?
And if you and Lilith got back together, you'd be his stepfather and his brother, and Niles would be your son and his own uncle. It's almost worth doing just so that I can tell the story.
So, Martin, what can you tell us about this pewter clock?
Well, it is a clock set in the stomach of what appears to be a bear.
Actually, it's much more than that. It's Russian, made in the mid-19th century.
That's pretty much what I figured.
Actually, it's a stunning piece. It was made by Andrei Karagin, who worked for Tsar Alexander II.
That is pretty much what I figured.
I don't know if you're descended from the Romanovs, Martin, but all of Karagin's known bear clocks were done exclusively for the Romanov family and are now in the Hermitage Museum in St. Petersburg. Martin, you may be surprised to learn that this clock at auction would easily bring $25,000.
Ka-ching!
What he means is, that's pretty much what we figured.
Hello.
Darling!
Sorry. Am I interrupting something?
Oh, not a thing, honey. Just take off your coat and stay alive.
Okay. I felt bad about that squabble earlier, so I thought I'd drop off this little piece off here.
As if I could stay mad at you. Edward, this is my boyfriend, Niles. No, I always told you boys that sports aren't important, but they are. And what you did tonight out there makes me really proud.
Thanks.
Good thing I wangled those tickets, eh, Dad?
Oh, look, Niles is on TV. Oh, I can't believe it. He made play of the week. We got us a real life celebrity in our own home. It's up, and it's good!
Dad, I can explain.
You threw my chair off the balcony?
I'm so sorry. Just hear me out.
Are you crazy?
I didn't mean to.
Forget what it means to me. You could have killed someone.
It was an accident.
You said there are no accidents.
Clearly, I was wrong. I mean, why on earth would I do such a thing?
Because you've always been gunning for that chair. I accidentally stain your carpet, and you set fire to the one thing in this apartment I care about, and heave it out into the street!
Dad, I am so sorry. I didn't mean to. Please forgive me. I'll buy you another chair.
Don't do me any favors.
No, please, Dad. Look, I know you're angry right now, and that's normal. I tell you what, the healthiest thing you can do right now...
You want to know the healthiest thing you can do?
Shut my yap!
Bingo!
Trying to embarrass me, it's not going to work.
Come here, Daddy's little peanut man.
But you gotta open your mind up. That's where all the great inventions come from. Like, it used to be if people would eat too much, their pants would get tight. Big problem. Then one day, somebody said, wait a minute, why not put elastic in them? Hi, Frege.
Dad, where are your pants?
In the fridge. I had a reason. Fridge pants.
Frasier has left the building.